Welcome to the Blazor Dropdown List tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to enable virtualization in the Syncfusion Blazor Dropdown List component. The Dropdown List component boosts UI performance with virtual scrolling. It loads a subset of items initially and dynamically adds more as you scroll, ensuring smooth user experience, especially with large data sets. Now let me open an existing Blazor web app in auto mode. If you want to know how to create a Blazor web app with auto mode selection, check the video linked in the description below. I have already added the Syncfusion drop-down list component and bound it to the data source property with a list of records as the data. Look here, I've added an example data source to the drop-down list, but you can also incorporate real-time data. If you want to learn how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Charts component to a Blazor web app, check out the video link provided in the YouTube card above. Let's run the example application. You'll notice the drop-down list component with the provided placeholder. Upon clicking the drop-down, 100 items are rendered in the drop-down list. However, I need to expand its capacity to display 1 lakh items within the drop-down list component. When you render a large number of items in the drop-down list, it may result in low performance, causing delays in rendering. To overcome this issue, I implement virtualization in the Blazor drop-down list component. First, I will make some changes to the code. I increase the item count from 100 to 1 million. To enable virtualization, I set the enable virtualization property to true in the Syncfusion Blazor drop-down list tag. Look now, initially the drop-down list rendered only 8 items based on the default pop-up height. When I scroll vertically, additional items are fetched and loaded on demand, allowing me to explore the complete dataset effortlessly. You can also adjust the number of items shown by utilizing the pop-up height property. This allows you to increase or decrease the number of items as per your requirement. Next, I'll demonstrate how to implement grouping with virtualization in the Blazor drop-down list component. To achieve this, I'll begin by making some changes to the code. Firstly, I add the group property within the record class. Then I'll create a private method named getRandomGroup, which takes the parameter as random. This method will generate a random group for a record object based on a given random instance. Inside the method, I uses a switch statement to evaluate the result of generating a random integer between 1 and 5 using the next method of the random object, determining which case in the switch statement will execute. Within the switch case, I return one of 4 predefined group names such as group A, group B, group C, and group D. Then I create a new instance of the random class and assigns it to the variable random. This instance of the random class is used to generate random numbers within the method where it's declared. Afterward, I'll update the group property to assign the created getRandomGroup method with the passed random parameter. Finally, I set the group by property to group within the drop-down list field settings tag. This property specifies that the drop-down items should be grouped. Look now, upon clicking the drop-down, you can see the drop-down rendered with provided group. When I scroll vertically, additional groups with items are fetched and loaded on demand. Next, I will demonstrate how to enable keyboard interaction in a drop-down list component. Users can navigate through the scrollable content using keyboard actions. This feature loads the next or previous set of items based on the key inputs in the pop-up. To achieve this, I initiate keyboard interaction. First, I press the arrow up key, which loads the previous virtual list item if the selection is present in the first item of the current page. Then, I press the arrow down key, which loads the next virtual list item if the selection is present in the last item of the current page. Next, I press the home key, which loads the initial set of items and selects the first item in it. Finally, I press the end key, which loads the last set of items and selects the last item in it. Next, I will show to enable preselection in Blazor drop-down list component. To begin, I declare an integer variable named selection index and set it to 7. Next, I add the bind index property and assign it to the selection index variable. This property ensures that the selected index is displayed initially. Look now, initially drop-down list rendered with the selected item. Next, I'll demonstrate how to enable filtering in the drop-down list component. To achieve this, I simply set the allow filtering property to true. Now, as you can see, upon clicking the drop-down, the filter box appears. Let's try filtering for item 57. See, the item 57 is now filtered in the drop-down list. Now, let me summarize. I showed you how to enable virtualization in the Blazor drop-down list component and grouping with virtualization. Also, I showed how to use keyboard interaction in drop-down list component. Additionally, I showed how to enable selection and filtering in Blazor drop-down list component. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.